Hey everyone, how's it going? Today we're going to be having a look at UV unwrapping, and we're going to be starting with something which all beginners need to know, and that's how to unwrap a cube. So this is a little bit more simple for some of our more advanced users, but this is going to be totally essential if you want to get into UV unwrapping, or maybe if you don't really know what it is. So today we'll be covering, first of all, how to unwrap a cube, then we'll be covering why it's important, and then we'll finish off with a quick quiz just to test your knowledge and hopefully commit it all to long-term memory. So let's go ahead and get started by pressing Shift and then the A button, and then under Mesh, I'm just going to choose Cube. Or if you have the default cube in your scene, you can just use that. Then what I'm going to do is come to this top left-hand corner. I'm going to use a brand new menu, and you'll see there's this cross shape that appears. So I'm just going to left-click and drag, and that's going to allow me to pull out a brand new menu. Then I'm just going to left-click this little symbol here, which is actually the symbol for the 3D viewport, which is what this workspace here is. And we can change this to anything here. You can even change this to a timeline, which is the thing on the bottom. But you can also change it to something called the UV editor. So I'm going to left click that, and this is what's going to actually allow us to be able to edit our UV. So I'll explain more about what this is in a second, but first of all, since this is a beginner tutorial, it makes sense to cover a little bit about what UV unwrapping actually is. So the reason why we do UV unwrapping in the first place is because usually we have some kind of image texture that we need to go ahead and place on our model. But the problem is, images work in 2D, and our model here is a 3D object. So we need a way of flattening out our 3D model into a 2D form in order to apply the texture on it without any issues. So what we can do here is go ahead and add a very quick test texture, just so we can see things. So I'll come down to this bottom right-hand corner, and you can see there's this option here called Material Properties. I'll just press plus new. By base color, you can just click this yellow dot, and I'll choose Image Texture, and I'll press plus new, and here, we're just going to change the generated type from blank to UV grid, and I'll just press new image. Now we can see how the UV is working. If you can't see yours in the solid mode, which is what I'm in just now to save performance, you just need to left click this arrow here, come down to where it says object color, and just choose texture. And now you can see it in here, which is pretty good. So what is the point of all these squares on this grid? Well, this just allows us to see whether or not there's any stretching being applied to our texture. So really what we're looking for when we're UV unwrapping is to have all of these things as close to the square as possible. Now when we're working with a little bit more complex objects, it's going to be harder to get every single thing square, so we sometimes just want to aim to as good as possible, but you can get pretty close to it most of the time if you UV unwrap properly. And we'll cover a little bit more of the ins and outs as we go on in this video. So first of all, you can see this is looking pretty good. It doesn't really have any stretching, and that's because Blender actually unwraps our cube by default. But today I want to show you how to actually do it, because this is a really important bit of 3D to understand, especially if you need to UV unwrap an object which looks a bit like a cube but hasn't been unwrapped. So you can see how on the left here in my UV editor, to get into this by the way, all I done was I came into my object and pressed tab, and now I can see things in here. Now in order to be able to see this cross shape, which you can just faintly see in my window here, you need to come into edit mode and make sure you press A to select all of the faces. So think of it as A for all. And then on the left here, if you can't really see this, you can just press A. And here we go. You can see roughly where it's lining up here. And Blender's very kindly gone ahead and put the texture in here to let me visualize a little bit more about what's happening. If I drag this out a little bit, you can see that I can choose an image from the drop down here. And that way I can preview what texture is showing up in here. And you can see that each of these faces are correspondent on here. So that's a little bit the basics of how this works. So how could we actually go ahead and UV unwrap this cube if we were needing to start from the start? Well, first of all, we need to mess up. So I'll just press A, and then I'm going to choose U. I'm just going to open up this unwrap menu, and I'm just going to choose reject from view. And now you can see it's just done that like that. But for now, we're going to go ahead and fix this. So to unwrap a cube, I just want you to think of this shape here. I'm going to get the pen, and it's going to look something like this. This kind of squared out U shape. And in order to unwrap a cube, you just need to have three of these U shapes all beside each other. So that's why when I'm teaching UV unwrapping, I like to say is remember the three U's. So how can we go ahead and apply this onto our object? Well, we need to select these edges. Now to select edges, you need to come to the top here, and you can see there's quite a few different things here. I've got face select mode, and when I left click that, that allows me to select faces, but we want to select edges for this. So you just choose this option here, and it's also 2 on the keyboard if you want a hotkey for that. If you want a way to remember the hotkey, just think of it as how every edge has 2 vertices, so number 2. Now, I'll go ahead and left click one of these edges, and we can just go ahead and shift left click these here. So I'll start off with this one here, and then I'm just going to come around to here, And now what you'll notice is we have two of these U shapes. So I've got one here, and then I've got one here as well. And then I'll come around to the other side, and I'll just shift left click these two as well. And there we go, that's us all done. So all we need to do now to actually UV unwrap this is we need to do something called marking a seam. Now by seam, what they mean is like a cut, because essentially what we're doing is we're cutting this object up in the UV editor in order to flatten it out into a 2D form, which makes it much easier to apply textures to, as you can see here. So the easiest way to do this is to go ahead and press Control and then E, and then we can go ahead and choose Mark Seam. There's a few different ways to mark seams in Blender 4.5, so I'll go ahead and talk a little bit about that in some future upcoming videos. But that's just going ahead and mark the seams. And right now, if I press A, you can see there's no difference. And that's because we need to unwrap, unless you have auto unwrap on, which is a little bit outside the scope of this video. So all I'm going to do is press A, like I've done here, to select everything. And then I'm going to press U. And then I'm just going to choose unwrap angle based. And now you can see we've got our cross shape again. Now, last very important thing to remember when we're UV unwrapping is the importance of applying the scale. So if I go back into object mode here, so just click down here and go to object mode and press S, which is the scale button, which allows us to change the size of our object. And I'm just going to press, for the sake of argument, the X button. That's going to allow me to scale on the X axis. You can notice, this has kind of caused some issues here. And now there are some ways to kind of avoid this. We can maybe stretch it in edit mode, for example, or something like that. But a lot of the time, you just want to change some of these transforms in object mode because it'd be a bit easier. So what do we do here? Because this is a bit of an issue. Well, what we need to do is apply the scale, because to kind of simplify what Blender is thinking is right now, is it's still seeing this object as a normal cube in terms of UV unwrapping here. And it's also going to be thinking of it as still a cube in a few other areas as well, such as procedural materials or rigging and things like that. So applying the scale is important for quite a few different things, but it's really important in UV unwrapping too. So if I go and press Tab into edit mode, press A, select everything, press U, and then choose unwrap angle based, you can see we've still got the same UV unwrap after unwrapping when we've clearly got some rectangular shapes here. So something strange is happening. And this is what I mean when I say that Blender is still treating this like a normal cube when we're unwrapping. So to fix this, all I need to do is press Tab to go back into object mode. And then I'm going to press the Control key, and then I'll press the A key while holding that down. And this will open up this Apply menu. And then all I need to do is choose Apply the Scale. And nothing will happen straight away. All we need to do now is press Tab to go back into edit mode, A, select everything, U, and then we'll choose unwrap angle based again. And now you can see it's done a little bit of a better job, which is pretty good. And we probably want to unwrap this a little bit different if we were starting with this cuboid shape. But overall, this is a nice connected UV unwrap, and it's connected quite seamlessly like that. So that should work pretty fine, although I probably would do a better job if I was starting with this kind of shape. But you can understand how the principles of how we'd unwrap it are the same. We would go ahead and use the free use, and that would be a great way to unwrap this object. And it's the same for any kind of cuboid object. Even if I go ahead and let's say, don't need to follow along with this. I'm just going to press Control R, add a loop cut, Control B to bevel, and I'll press free on the keyboard and press E to pull this out. Then all I would need to do here is separate off this section and then unwrap this as a cube as well. And then it would just be like two cubes joined together. So we can maybe touch on a little bit more of that in the future if you guys would be interested. But we'll go ahead and wrap up the video there. I hope that serves as a good introduction for you for UV unwrapping in Blender. We'll have a quick quiz as well. So first of all, I want you to remember, how did we memorize unwrapping the cube? So the answer was we need to remember these free use. And to be honest, probably should have hid this here. It's probably not very helpful. But we can use the free use in order to remember how to unwrap a cube. So now when you think back to the beginning of the video and think about why do we UV unwrap in the first place? So pause the video and give that a think. Now essentially the reason why we UV unwrap in the first place is because textures are 2D and objects here are 3D. And so we need to break down our object into a 2D form in the UV editor in order to apply a texture on it without it looking like a stretched, distorted mess. So that's essentially the basics. I hope you did find that useful. And next time we'll go ahead and move on to the cylinder. Take care.